Victorious Pentecostal Assembly, Canaan Land. A place to worship the Most High God. A place of salvation. A place where righteousness and holiness is a...
Church Jesus! Lift up your heart as you receive. I declare that from today, you shall escape from the mystery of this world. I say you will escape from the mystery of this world. In the name of Jesus Christ, I say by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I command every chain of the enemy in your life is broken tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, every voice speaking against your life, against your destiny, I command it to be silent by the power of the Holy Ghost. Church Jesus, lift up your heart. Every evil pronouncement made against you, I declare judgment of God upon your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, Church Jesus. Tell your neighbor you are victorious. Where are we now? Where are we? In victorious, where God's presence is, you are victorious. Sit down and put a laughter in your mouth. Say, my time has come. Isaiah 61, verse 1-3. Are we there? Let me read. He said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Because the Lord God has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has set me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourns, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beautiful arches, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might become trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that they might be glorified. Say, my time has come. Say, my time has come. Say, I am accepted. I am accepted. Bible declare in 2 Corinthians 3 verse 17. Say, now the Lord is that spirit. And where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Wherever God is, there is freedom. So the presence of God is what guarantees liberty in our life. See, my time has come. And then the presence of God is what guarantees liberty in the world of bondage. I say your liberty is guaranteed. Until the spirit is present, yoke and bodies will remain. But when the spirit of God manifests himself in your life, every yoke, no matter how tough, no matter how powerful the body is, no matter how heavy, they will bow before Jesus. Say, my time has come. Someone is here, that yoke in your life tonight, it will give way. It will give way. I said, someone is here. You came here with a heavy body. The Lord said, I should tell you that that body shall be taken away from you now. I said, now. See, I believe that. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of mystery. That's why you must understand the mystery. You must understand the mystery. The mystery. And when you understand the mystery, no matter the news that is going around the world, you are not part of it. You are accepted. There is a kingdom mystery which I don't joke with. I always want to always let you know it time to time. I don't joke with it, and I call it the mystery in the anointing oil. Don't joke with it. Today, the mystery shall deliver the secret of divine earth in the midst of calamity into your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, Jesus said in Mark 4 verse 11, said, and he said unto them, unto you it is given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God, but unto them that are without, all those things are done in parable. Understanding the mystery of the kingdom is what makes you a champion in life. There is a connection between the oil and divine earth. There is an anointing that confirms divine earth upon men. It does not matter what happened to others. If you understand the mystery behind the anointing oil, you will enjoy what? Supernatural earth. You will enjoy, you will not fall victim in disasters. You will fall victim. I say you will fall victim. To them mark the end of sickness for your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, say my time has come. God, I say God has a covenant of divine earth with you. He said in Jeremiah 13 verse 6, said, behold, I will bring it earth and cure. I will bring it earth and cure, and I will cure them, and I will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. So earth and cure is your portion. Therefore, every sickness and disease is now under your feet. The devil himself is under your feet. Deuteronomy 7 verse 50 said, and the Lord will take away from thee all sickness, and I will put none of this evil disease of Egypt, which thou knowest, upon thee, but I will lay them upon all that ate thee. So the enemy are the one that must carry problems. The enemy are meant to be afflicted, not you. One of the diseases of Egypt is sickness, affliction. The Bible, promise of God is that he will not allow the disease of Egypt to come on us. So it takes a higher power to destroy the power of enemy in our life, which we have via the higher power. So one of the mysteries of the kingdom assigned by God to destroy the work of the enemy is the anointing. The anointing. Package in a bottle. It might look like oil, but it's not oil. Very active. What is the anointing? What is the anointing? The oil is ordinary oil. Until the power of God come upon it, when the power of God come upon the oil, it became a kingdom mystery that break yoke and destroy bodies. Say, my time has come. The oil is one of the ways in which power is transferred into the life of God's children. So the oil is an instrument that God used to break yoke of the enemy. The oil is not Holy Ghost, but it is the medium through which the Holy Ghost operate. Don't condemn it. The oil is a command from God. It's a command from God. You find it in Exodus 13, verse 31. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, this shall be an holy anointing oil unto me throughout your generation. Is it your Bible? Open it. Exodus 30, 31. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, this shall be an holy anointing oil unto me throughout your generation. Is it your Bible? You cannot see. It's a commandment from God throughout your generation. When the power of the Holy Ghost come upon the oil, it become the anointing oil. The anointing, it works. I say it works. When the power of God comes upon the oil, it became a kingdom mystery that break yokes and destroy bodies. I said the oil is one of the ways in which transfer power into the life of his children. Say, my time has come. This evening, the power of the anointing is coming on you. I say it's coming on you. Say, I receive it. What is the mystery of the anointing oil? What is the mystery? Number one, the oil is the power of God for sass and water. The oil is what? The power of God for what? Acts 10:38 said, our God anointed Jesus, our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the oil, with the Holy Ghost, and with power. Our God anointed Jesus, that is Jesus, his son, with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Jesus needed the power of the anointing to become a sons and wonder to his generation. He needed it to fulfill his destiny. So this morning, this evening, whatever will not allow you to fulfill your destiny by this anointing, they shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Your lifting is coming. I say your lifting is coming. James 5 verse 14. He said, is any sick among you? Let him call for the elder of the church and let them pray over him and anoint him with the oil in the name of the Lord. This is the mystery of the oil. The anointing oil destroys sickness and he prevents the devil. He draw a lamb. Touch not. He draw a lamb. Even today, after the prayer point, I'm going to anoint everybody in this church. Church, the oil is not for decoration. As you have, as the point of your hand, declare whatever is a stranger in my life. Today, out of my life. Start the prayer now. As they put it in your hand and not your forehead, I'll be praying. Whatever represents a stranger in my life, whatever is not godly in my life, that is feasting in my body, you are a stranger. Out. Let there be a prayer point to you quickly. Say whether the devil like it or not. Whether the devil like it or not. Enough is enough. This issue, I've overcome you. Enough is enough. Say, I release the blood of Jesus, the anointing, to scatter every power working against my head, working against my life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, in the name of Jesus, I decree every gag up, every gag up in the realm of the spirit, against my sources, against my progress, scatter by fire. Every gag up, every gag up in the air, in the sea, in this land, in the realm of the spirit, against my sources, against my destiny, scatter by fire in the name of Jesus. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
I'm not to inform what the oil is being passed. We are praying. I'm not being the spirit. Bible declared in Isaiah 54 verse 15. He said, behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against them, they shall fail for them sake. Say, I command in my place of birth, this country, I command every captain of the enemy against me, in the sea, in the land, in the air, scattered by the fire of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. Say, I decree every arrow of sickness, arrow of affliction, fire into my life. What are you waiting for? Be uprooted now. Right about to set them. Church Jesus.
Jesus.
Say, my time has come. Say, every stranger of affliction, every stranger in my life, come out, come out, come out, come out. come out in the name of Jesus. Every storm of affliction in my life, be uprooted, be uprooted, be uprooted. I command this wrong, I command this stone, roll back and destroy in the name of Jesus. Every sort of affliction in my life, be uprooted by fire, by force. Roll back to your setup, roll back to your setup in the name of Jesus. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Matthew 15 verse 13. He answered and said, Jesus answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted shall be uprooted. Every plant my heavenly Father has not planted must be uprooted. Say, I command. Every root of sickness, every root of disease, every root of affliction in my life, be uprooted by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Church Jesus.
Jesus.
Isaiah 66 verse 15. He said, for behold, the Lord will come with fire and with a chariot like a whirlwind to rather his anger with fury and his rebuke with flame of fire. Say the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God be released against my enemy in the name of Jesus. 1 Corinthians 10 verse 26 says, for the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Say, because the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, let everything in this earth rise up and fight against the enemy of my destiny in the name of Jesus. Every chain, every rope, every iron used to catch my destiny, break by the reason of the anointing. Break now, break now. Say, I lose myself by fire, by force. Every manipulation in the name of Jesus. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Psalm 18 verse 13. He said, the Lord has thunder in the heavens, and the highest gave his voice. Hailstone and coast of fire. Say, enough is enough. Say, let stones and cloud of fire be released against the head of my enemy in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. This is the word of God. In Psalm 80 that he said, the Lord has thunder in the heaven, and the highest gave his voice. A stone and coat of fire. Say, enough is enough. Say, let the stone and the coat of fire be released against the head of those who are planning evil against me. Say, enough is enough. Every trap of affliction planning against me, catch fire and be destroyed. Say, enough is enough. Say, I resist. I resist every arrow of affliction against the enemy. I resist it in the name of Jesus. Say, I command fire of God. I slay every arrow of sickness, arrow of fire, arrow of affliction. I slay them in the name of Jesus. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Job 22 verse 28 say, that also decree a thing, and it shall come and shall be established, and unto them, and the light shall shine upon their ways. Say, enough is enough. Say, enough is enough. Say, I decree all that concerns me in the heart of evil strong men. Lose them. I lose them now. And I possess my possession now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Isaiah 8 verse 9. He said, associate yourself, O ye people, and you shall be broken in pieces. And give ears, O ye far country. Guard yourself, and you shall be broken in pieces. Guard yourself, and you shall be broken in pieces. Say, enough is enough. Say, I decree. Every evil association that has taken up my earth and my well-being as the agenda, wherever you are, scatter by fire in the name of Jesus. Every moderate devices that is being used to moderate my earth, I command you, be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Child Jesus.
Jesus.
Say, my time has come. Say, the Spirit of the living God. Isaiah 59 verse 9. He said, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the storm, where the enemy shall come in like a flood. The Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against them. Lift up your hand up. Say, by the Spirit of the Lord. Say, by the Spirit of the living God, I rise up. I rise up. I rise up. The Spirit, I rise up the standard of God against every enemy of my soul in the name of Jesus. Say, I reject every evil lord in my life. And I decree they are consumed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
1 Samuel 2 verse 8. He said, he raised up the poor out of the dust, and he lifted the beggar from the door in, to set them among princes, and to make them inherited the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord, and he has set the word upon them. Say, I decree, I am lifted above every negative situation. I am lifted. I am lifted. I am lifted by the blood of Jesus. I renounce and I break every curses of backwardness, failures at the edge of breakthrough. I renounce them. I renounce them. I renounce them. I am lifted. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Psalm 91 verse 10. There shall no evil before them. And I shall then any plan come near your dwelling. Say, I decree. No sickness, no poverty, no loneliness, no affliction shall come near me and my household. Say, nothing shall cut my life short. The Lord shall fulfill the numbers of my days. I shall live and declare the words of God. I shall live and declare the words of God. I shall live to declare the words of God. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Say, my time has come. Isaiah 59 verse 9 said, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun, with enemies shall come like a flood. Excuse me, Lord. This is what is about to manifest now. Say, my time has come. Can we appreciate Jesus again? We can do better. 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 Church Jesus!
Jesus!